Rais wa tatu wa Jamhuri ya Kenya, Mheshimiwa Mwai Kibaki na family ya Kibaki, kiongozi wa taifa na rais wa Jamhuri ya Kenya, Mheshimiwa Uhuru Kenyatta, na mama wa taifa, Mama Margaret. Can somebody help me with this? Rafiki wetu rais wa Jamhuri ya Tanzania ambaye amestahafu, Mheshimiwa Jakaya Kikwete, ndugu viongozi wote waliofika hapa na wananchi wa Nyeri na ndugu zetu wa Kenya kutoka mahali mbalimbali, hamjambo. Ando aito muriega. Mwadhani agosho. Ngai no muega. Ende shode. We have come here as a nation for the final send-off of our former First Lady, Mama Lucy Kibaki. And before I make very brief remarks, I know in our midst we have many leaders. I am going to ask all members of counties' assemblies with their speakers to stand up so that we can recognize them. Waheshimiwa wote wa bunge zetu za kaunti wasimame. Asanteni sana, tuwapigie makofi. Kati yetu pia tuko na wabunge wetu wote wa taifa la Kenya pamoja na masenators ambao hawatapata nafasi ya kuongea, pia wasimame tuwapigie makofi. Asanteni sana. Miongoni wetu pia tuko na principal secretaries and cabinet secretaries who are present here, wasimame ili tuwapigie makofi. Asanteni sana. Hawa wote hawatapata nafasi ya kuongea, lakini wamekuja hapa kusimama na wewe, rais wetu wa tatu wa Jamhuri ya Kenya, katika mazishi haya ya mama wetu wa taifa, Mama Lucy Kibaki. And before I invite our friend, the former president of Tanzania, let me just say two things about Mama Lucy Kibaki. Mama Lucy Kibaki was special, and she did what she believed in, not what we all expected her to do. Many Kenyans, myself included, thought the role of the First Lady is to be seen, not to be heard. But Lucy Kibaki changed that. She was not only seen, we had to listen to her. She made it impossible for us to ignore her. And she became a big influence on the Kibaki presidency. Apart from changing the role of the First Lady and giving it the stature that it deserves and setting the standard where I see our current First Lady has kept that standard now. It's different. So she has brought a lot of influence to the office of the First Lady. She became a big influence in the Kibaki presidency because she was firm and honest. Many brokers and hypocrites and pretenders and lazy people had a difficult time around the Kibaki presidency because of Lucy. In many occasions, she gave those people magic orders. And so she has carved a niche for herself in the nation of Kenya. I had occasion, as I said, on many occasions to interact with her, but a very special one. In Eldoret, after President Kibaki had come for campaigns and I was the local member of parliament, and I had made some remarks which she didn't like very much. And so when we were walking out, I found the first lady had stopped to wait for me. And she gave me some piece of advice. And she did it in a very motherly manner. And before long, President Kibaki told Lucy, it's time to go. And the most memorable was in 2010 at State House, after the normal celebrations and garden party. As I said, askari moja alikuja akaniambia, mama wa taifa anakutafuta. Amesema uende umuone. Pale nikaanza kuwaza mambo mengi na nikaanza kutafuta kama kuna mahali nimekosea. Lakini nilipoenda kumuona, na baadaye nilimwarifu rais wetu Uhuru Kenyatta, aliniambia, fanya kazi na ndugu yako Uhuru Kenyatta. I later came and told my friend, the president, that that is what Lucy had said. And I guess that's why I am deputy president of Kenya today. So Mama Lucy was special to all of us in many ways. And I know he was special to President Kibaki as his friend, as the mother of his children, and as Jimmy and Judy and Tony and David have said, she was very special to them as mother. And to all of us, it is a loss to a mother figure for our country, and we have come here in all humility to give her a very befitting send-off. It's now my pleasure to ask President Jakaya Kikwete, the former president of Tanzania, to make his remarks. Mr. President.